Hey, it's Denise, and I'm starting this video again because I seem to have a propensity for accidentally hitting the stop button when I'm in the middle of filming a video with my phone. Anyway, it's only been about a week since I showed you that I planted zinnias in my largest Aerogarden farm, which is in my hallway upstairs. And zinnias are non-toxic to cats and dogs. As I've mentioned in other videos, I'm getting a puppy. The litter is due at the end of this month, which is November. It's mid-November. So at 6 weeks, I get to go pick my puppy. I have this first choice of females. And then at 9 weeks, I would get to bring her home. So let's talk about, you know, yes, puppy-proofing is incredibly important, just like you would child-proof if you had a toddler, but these zinnias I made sure were safe to grow, because if we're walking by and she grabs a leaf or a flower, I wanted to make sure they're non-toxic. You can watch my puppy videos if you're interested in that, but this is a gardening video, so I just wanted to remind you, even though it's only been a week and you might be saying, okay Denise, these are not big bushy flowers yet, but hey, you're not going to get big bushy flowers in a week. What I did want to show you, however, was, and keep in mind, I'm still getting the hang of using my camera and focusing in on the right thing. Okay. You see the dates on these seeds? 2018. I didn't use any of these seeds in my 2020 garden. I used some outdoors in very large muck bucket type planters, just to have them around my garden to attract pollinators, and they're absolutely beautiful. So these seeds are a couple years old. That's why, even though for this garden space, ideally I probably need about three plants. You can see, once again, I mentioned the last video, but in case you didn't watch that video, these wires attach by a magnetic attachment on each end that just clips on. And then there are clips which you kind of pinch and clip for the cross pieces. So I've divided it into one, I'm terrible at pointing, one, two, three. Zinnias of this variety, at least, are supposed to be planted 12 to 18 inches apart. Now, considering that they will not be competing with weeds or grass or other plants for water or nutrients or artificial sunlight because of the grow lights. Have I blinded you before with a direct view of the grow lights above the... Now, these are adjustable. If I wanted them lowered down closer to the plants while they were germinating, I could do that. But I find that unnecessary. These are germinating beautifully. And the reason I wanted to show you that these seeds were a couple years old was, like I said, I didn't even use any last year. I used them the year before outdoors. And with each year that you keep seeds, you can expect a little bit of a drop in germination rate. And that's assuming that you've been properly storing them in a, you know, cool, dry place, keeping them from getting damp, keeping them from, you know, conditions where they might try to sprout, which is basically damp and warm. So I planted 8 seeds, hoping to get 3. And I figured any extras are just bonuses. As you can see, at the side of the garden, there's plenty of space right here where I could just put a flower pot if I have an extra one. Same thing at the other end. I could clear that watering can and plant food and stuff and put a flower pot there, and they would get plenty of light from the extra light that the Aerogarden throws. I've done it before with other plants and they worked out fine. So out of 8 seeds, from these 2018 seeds, a big housefly. I get a big housefly about every 2 or 3 days. It's driving me nuts. The temperatures are well below freezing at night, yet every 2 or 3 days, a giant housefly wants to be around my garden. I do have the ugly fly tape hanging. Specifically, you see that little thing I stuck to the wall? That's one of the Aerogarden baskets, and you can see I cut the connectors that hold the pieces together, and I'm using it to kind of take the tape, which is attached to the wall out on the other side of the Aerogarden, and sort of direct it in because those flies seem attracted to the bright light that the Aerogarden sheds. Anyway, back to the seedlings. Out of my 8 what some people might consider outdated seeds, out of 8, 6 of them have successfully germinated. Now, I keep putting my finger in front. I apologize. I'm still getting used to filming more with my phone instead of my computer. And as you can see, they've gotten their first set of true leaves. So while these are the leaves that open when the seed opens, that other set is what you refer to as the first set of true leaves, if you're not familiar with that term. And it's just a good indicator that your plant is really off to a start. It didn't just, the seed opened and then, you know, it's not doing well. The fact that true leaves are starting to grow is an excellent sign that your plant is doing well. I only have 2 on this side. This one also has its second set of leaves, I should say, first set of true leaves, to give you an idea of height. Now, are they giants? No, they're not giants. Let me just put my fingers here next to them, maybe 3 fingers. They're about 3 fingers tall. But again, the fact that they've gotten those true leaves growing, to me, is an excellent sign. Over here, we've got 4. And again, I'm going to split these. Right now, their root systems are so small, they're probably not even sticking out of the little peat. I may be surprised. Yes, you can just start to see. Can you see that? That little string? That is part of the root system that is reaching down for the water in the Aerogarden. Now, the Aerogarden, through those little spouts, which I've showed you, I'm going to totally put my hand in the way. I'm going to point with the plastic thing. Right there is the spout, that 15 minutes out of every 60, and that's something that you can adjust. I happen to have them to water for 15 minutes out of every hour, and it trickles water into the grow sponge. Because, of course, initially your seeds cannot reach down into the water reservoir. So they're counting on the water that's being trickled into the grow sponge for their moisture. As you can see, these little plants, and again, let me get down to plant level just so we can give you fingers. This one is probably only about 2 fingers tall. It's not as tall as the other one. But again, it's got the first set of true leaves. It's green, it's healthy, I'm thrilled with it. Over here, we've got this one, which is doing quite well. This one, which is getting quite big. This one also getting quite big. Now, this was my late bloomer. I really thought I was getting 5 out of 8 seeds, which again, I was no complaints here. They're seeds from 2018. And a lot of people under the false belief that at the end of the gardening season, you have to throw out your seeds. Please, please, please don't do that. Especially if it's a variety that you liked. Tape up that seed packet, put it in a plastic bag, and just keep it in a relatively cool, dark part of the house. Mine have traditionally been in a cardboard box. I recently relocated them to, if you watch some of my videos, I reorganized them to a plastic container, which is like a craft or photograph container. Each plastic little suitcase basically has 16 boxes that look almost like the size that you would put, I'm going to date myself here, but like a VHS or, you know, that type of videotape kind of shaped box. They say they're for crafts or photo organization. They work beautifully for organizing your seeds by type. Don't throw away your seeds at the end of the season. Seeds are good for years as long as you store them even half, you know, as perfectly as you should. I by no means stored mine perfectly. And to get 6 plants out of 8 seeds, you wouldn't complain about that if you had just bought the seeds this year. That would be within an acceptable germination rate. So to get that germination rate out of seeds from 2 years ago, I'm very happy with that. And I just wanted to show you, and I will continue to show you as they get larger. Hopefully they stay healthy. Hopefully, you know, once I see they're a little bigger and I'm confident that they're all doing well, the 3 that are going to stay in the Aerogarden, I will move into where I think they're spaced equally, so that again, this little grid system of, you know, 3 supportive wires, you know, I'll have 1 plant in each, probably sort of 1 in the middle of here, 1 towards the edge of either of these, which will grow in the middle section, and 1 sort of in the middle or off to the right of here, so it'll grow in this end section. And then, like I said, if I have extras, they can go in nice size flower pots and sit on the bench either here or here, or I can put them downstairs somewhere completely different. I do have some grow lights downstairs. They're not Aerogarden lights. I do have an Aerogarden in my kitchen. It throws some light on my little citrus trees. I have a pink lemon and a tangerine. Now, they're not the most exciting plants. Probably I could be taking better care of them, but they do get some light from my Aerogarden, and I do have 1 extra clip-on. It's not the full spectrum with the white, but it is the blue and red light, and it just gives them a little extra light. I've never grown citrus before, so for me they are an experiment. But I just wanted to show you, once again, if you grow a variety and you like it, do not throw away the seeds at the end of the season. Tape up the packet. You can kind of see here, you know, I ripped the packet open like a lot of people do. I planted them and then I just folded it over and taped them. And again, these are from 2018. I didn't even bother using any last year because I wasn't in a position to do outdoor gardening. And my indoor gardening was focused on more food production type plants, which a lot of which weren't particularly successful. Some were, but not a lot. And I decided that for the winter, I just wanted to have some color and something that I knew wasn't going to be toxic for a puppy slash dog, and especially because it's in the hallway leading to her bedroom. So do not buy into that, you know, they want you to throw them out. The seed companies want you to throw them out at the end of the season and buy new ones next year. That's how they make their money. But as you can see, these seeds, which are a couple years old, beautifully germinated 6 out of 8 seeds. And again, if it was a new packet of seeds, you would not complain about that germination rate. So the fact that it's a 2-year-old package of seeds, I'm definitely happy with that germination rate. So again, you know, don't be conned. Don't waste your money by throwing things out at the end of the gardening season that can be used next year. Just put them in a little Ziploc bag. Put them in a box where they're out of the sun and out of the moisture. They're not freezing. They're not baking. And that's about what I did. I mean, I didn't take special care of them. And as you can see, they kept for 2 years beautifully. And I will update you as these plants get bigger. Hopefully they all continue to grow. But, you know, if I lose any, I will share that with you. And I just wanted to show what a difference a week can make, especially because, like I said, this was the last one to pop up. I think it's still the smallest. Am I pointing at it? Let's do the finger test. Oh, I just whacked it. Yeah, this one's like just barely two fingers high. My pinky's under there. So yeah, just barely two fingers high. It was the last one. I was actually starting to think that this one hadn't seeded, but then I realized I'd put the seed in upside down, so the plant needed extra time to grow and sort of turn a circle. Am I just confusing things with my big old fingers? It needed to turn a circle under the soil and come up. So that took a couple extra days. My bad for putting the seed in upside down. But yeah, 6 out of 8 germinated out of 2-year-old seeds. So let that be a lesson not to waste your seeds by throwing them out at the end of the gardening season, especially again when you love the variety. Cut and come again zinnias, as the name implies. They only get about 24 inches high. You can see there are a variety of colors. I don't know what colors these plants will be. The seeds are mixed. I don't really care what color the plants are. I hope they're not all white. That would be a little bit boring. But other than that, I don't really care what color they are. And as the name implies, once they bloom, cut them at the bottom of that bloom, you know, before the where it meets the stem that it comes off of, and it will set more flowers. Now, I've only grown zinnias outside, and it's the frost that usually kills them. So, I don't know. They might last for a very long time continuing to rebloom if they're indoors, depending on if they do have a sort of set determinate lifespan, or if they're just going to keep blooming over and over until frost, which of course is not going to happen in the house, would kill them. So if you find a variety you like, and like I said, these only get to be about 2 feet tall, whereas some of your zinnias get over 3 feet tall. Now, I love zinnias in all varieties. If you watch me talk about plants before, you know that. I've bought a bunch of zinnias for the spring, which I'll grow outside, which get much taller. But I just thought for this hallway space and these Tractor Supply wood chip bags are going to be out of the way, hopefully shortly, so you won't be feeling like you're squeezing by them when you walk past the garden here. I just think that having some zinnias over the winter, because it's mid-November, and it is already quite dead looking here in the Adirondacks. We've had multiple freezes, and the idea that I could have some beautiful, you know, lush green, multicolor flowering zinnias over the winter just makes my soul happy. So I hope this was informative. I hope it gives you an idea of just how easy hydroponic gardening can be. And I hope it encourages you, whether it's flowers or lettuces or, you know, other plants that can be grown hydroponically. I would not suggest root vegetables. Like, you know, you're not going to grow carrots in here. You're not going to grow parsnips in here. But plants that the root system can be in water and in nutrients, but the main plant that you want is above that, especially if you have a farm model like this, which has the full 3 feet of grow space, you know, a vertical grow space, you can put a lot of lettuce or a lot of kale or a lot of my personal favorite Swiss chard as far as greens go, especially if you're picking them young. So don't be, you know, put off by the fact that I'm opting to only grow 3 plants. That's because these 3 plants are meant to be planted 18 inches apart, 12 to 18 inches apart. So I don't want them totally crowding each other, and I want them to be able to really do well. Anyway, please like, subscribe, check out my other videos, hit the notification bell. I don't think at the beginning I said, hi Denise and welcome to my channel if you've never been here, and welcome back if you have been. I try to do that. I do appreciate very much people who take the time to watch my videos. I especially appreciate when you take the time to share them. You have no idea what a difference that makes for someone who's trying to grow their YouTube channel if you can just share the video on social media. Comment especially if you've used either Aerogardens or, and I am not affiliated with them in any way, I just happen to find them to be the easiest gardens to use, especially because I bought my first one as someone with zero hydroponic experience. They walk you through on the screen how to set them up, what to do, you know, how many hours of daylight, how much water, etc., for the different kind of plants you're growing. But if you like hydroponic gardening, if you like container gardening in the house during the winter, I'm in zone 4B, so my outdoor growing season is very short. And if you found this helpful or interesting or motivating, or maybe it's going to get you to grow some things over the winter, again, please do like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, share the video with other people who might be like-minded. Ignore those tractor supply bags, which I swear I'm going to get moved out of here soon. It's just a matter of rearranging. I had to empty an entire room to make room for my puppy, who should be coming by the end of January, first week of February. And I just wanted the room set up for her, and that room had been largely storage. And these are two things that, you know, these two bags were stored in there, so I've got to find somewhere else to put them. So again, I hope you enjoyed it. I hope you enjoy seeing that saving your seeds from year to year saves you money and brings you joy. So I'm looking forward to, you know, I like to always think positive. I'm looking forward to this hallway being filled with beautiful green plants, with beautiful colorful flowers on them that I know are not toxic if my young dog sort of just grabs at them as we're walking by. I've done plenty of reading. Whether she eats a leaf or a flower, it's not going to hurt her. I mean, you're not going to sit here and intentionally feed them to her, because a bunch of them could make her sick. But if she were to grab one and eat it, it's not going to hurt her. And from what I've read, the same is true for cats. So Zinnia are something that are safe to grow around cats and dogs. I did not check for other animals. Again, I appreciate if you like, subscribe, hit the notification bell, check out my other playlists. I do things on a variety of topics. If you've only watched my gardening videos, you might enjoy some of my other videos. I do unboxings, I do product reviews, I do my opinions on things that are primarily related to health, disability, migraines in particular, invisible illnesses that sometimes people, you know, give you that you don't look disabled to me look, which I have to say is something that aggravates the hell out of me. I had a successful nursing career for 26 years, which I loved, which made me financially independent. And because of a spinal cord injury, I lost that. So on the outside, I look fine because my neck self-destructed from the inside. So when people look at me like, you look too young or too healthy to be parked in that handicap spot, I just feel like giving them the finger, quite frankly. And I know that sounds very aggressive, but if you've received that look or those snide comments enough, you understand what I'm talking about. Again, I digress. You know I do this if you watch my videos. But again, it's, you know, check out my other playlists if you're interested in videos that are on things other than just gardening. And if you're just interested in gardening, then watch my gardening playlists. Anyway, I do truly, from the heart, appreciate that you take the time to watch. And have a great evening. Well, I'm saying evening because it's evening here. And have a great whatever time it is when you watch this. And again, look at those little beauties. Getting taller as each day grows by. Did you see, hear me? I said grows by instead of goes by. And I didn't even do it on purpose. So it was a mistake, but it made sense. Anyway, so you can see there's two. So that is 6 out of 8 seeds, even though the seeds are a couple years old. Again, they are cut and come again, mixed zinnias. And I won't know what colors I've gotten until they start flowering, which is kind of part of the fun. Like I said, it would kind of suck if they were all white, but again, white flowers are beautiful too. And I figure, what are the chances that they're all white? Hopefully there's some color thrown in there. I'm just happy to have some flowers growing. And I think for the winter, it will make my upstairs a just more happy area, which my soul appreciates in the winter when everything outside here in Zone B is butt deep in snow and quite dead looking. So I hope you enjoyed this. I hope you found it informative. And once again, thank you for taking the time to watch and have a wonderful day. Grow something.